Hello friends, welcome to my channel. So today we'll be baking some coffee bean cookies. They are infused with coffee and they are given a shape of the coffee bean. That's why they're called the coffee bean cookies. So we'll be making a healthy variant to it. Instead of using all-purpose flour, we'll be making something which is more healthier. So this I have about 100 grams of butter here. This is unsalted butter. You can also take salted butter. Then I have about 2 tablespoons of ghee. Make sure that the ghee and the butter are in the refrigerator and you just directly remove it and then make the cookies. It should not be melted. Here I have about 1 cup of whole wheat flour. I have about 1/4 cup of rice flour. I have about 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder. I have about 1/4 cup of almonds that I have grinded. I have some brown sugar. You can use normal sugar or jaggery instead. So I have grinded the brown sugar also. I have some water here, which we'll be using about 2 tablespoons. We have 2 tablespoons of coffee here, which is instant coffee. And we have some vanilla essence here. And some milk, just in case we need it. So let's look at the process. First, what we need to do is we have to take the butter and the ghee. And make sure they are combined well. So till they are combined, we will just keep stirring it. So now our butter has become fluffy. Now let's get the coffee decoction ready. So here we have about 2 tablespoons of coffee. To that we'll add about 2 tablespoons of milk, 2 tablespoons of warm water, and dissolve it. Keep this aside. And now to the butter mixture, we'll add the sugar, brown sugar, and the coffee decoction. And little vanilla essence. About 1 tablespoon of vanilla essence. This I'm using the natural vanilla essence, which is little thicker comparatively to the industrial ones which are available. So you can use the industrial ones also, but about 1 tablespoon should be good. Now mix it till you get a fluffy and light kind of a consistency in this. So keep mixing till you get about soft spikes in this. Now it's become light and fluffy. We've been mixing it for good 2 minutes. Now let's mix the flours. I have here 1 cup of whole wheat flour. To that I will add 1/4 cup of rice flour and cocoa powder and some crushed almonds. We'll sieve them well. Now I've sieved the flour. Let's try to mix it in the wet ingredients in 2 phases. So the first phase, just give it a gentle mix. Don't over knead the dough. And the second one. So make a one round ball which is not too hard or too soft. Basically something which comes together. Now our dough has come together. We will rest it for 10 minutes. In the meanwhile, we'll preheat our oven at 180 degrees for 10 minutes and also get our baking tray ready. Now 10 minutes are done. Let's take a small portion of the dough get it on a rolling place. Try to get the dough together. It'll break, but that's okay. You continue to roll out, and we need to, you know, get it into a proper round cylindrical shape. Now this is done. Let's cut them into small pieces. Once they are cut, we'll take them, hold it in our hand like this, give them some oval shape. Like a coffee bean. Flatten them. Make sure there are no cracks. Shape them like this. And take any sharp object or any knife or anything and give one. Take it like this. And in the center, just give like this. So that shapes like a coffee bean. Now we'll continue making the other cookies and line them on the baking tray. So our cookies are ready on the baking tray. So with the mixture, we are able to get about 30 cookies. Now we'll bake them in a preheated oven for about a minimum of about 20 minutes or till you see any crunch on the cookies. Now our cookies look done. We'll remove it from the oven. Transfer them on the cooling rack and we'll cool them for good 30 minutes before we bake them. So our cookies are baked now and they have cooled down also. They are extremely crumbly. I'll take one cookie and break it and show it to you guys. So you can hear the noise of crumbliness. Thank you friends for watching my recipes. I'm really glad I've been receiving a lot of feedback, lot of comments, lot of likes. And I expect the same from you. So keep liking the recipes, keep subscribing to my channel, and also don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you.